You know, I've said before that I'm not the smartest builder that ever lived, and over the course of the last 10 years, I think I've pretty well proved that. But even for a smart builder, I think the cowling presents a pretty big challenge for a couple of reasons. One is the instructions make no sense, especially to people like me, who learn by having people show you how things are done. That's why the websites that are out there, I think, are so valuable. Cowling's a different beast because in the absence of really good instructions, people have developed different ways of constructing it. And for somebody like me who depends on all of these various sites to have so many different ways that they can be done actually makes things a little bit more confusing. I've tried to follow the instructions, I've tried to follow the websites, and at the moment I'm kind of dead in the water because they don't really make a lot of sense with me, and I'll show you a couple of reasons why. But mostly what I'm looking for is to develop here kind of a step-by-step deal. I really need people to say to me, this is what you need to do next, this one little step is what you need to do next. And then after that we'll do this, and then after that we'll do that. The big picture on this thing is confusing me more than anything else, and of course the problem is that this is the thing that people walk up to in an Oshkosh, and if it looks like crap, you know, what fun is that? I'll show you what I mean. My friend Warren Starkeybaum flew over a little while ago and helped me get started on this sort of thing, telling me what to do, and I got the top put together okay, and I put the prop extension on and that sort of thing, and then it becomes time to do the bottom, and that's where I have a little bit of a problem. Although my instruction didn't say so, apparently the instructions say to take this thing off and put it together and get a circle here, and in fact I do have a 13 1/4 inch circle put together. The problem I have is that the fit is crappy, and I don't know how uncrappy it has to be before it works. Take a closer look. I don't even know if you can tell how crappy that really is here, but this is a pretty wide separation under here. This doesn't fit quite right. It separates over here. I looked at Brantell's site, and he had sliced off this to get this to fit. I think I did that just because he did that, which was kind of stupid. And so I've got this really horrible fitting nonsense here. And you go over to the other side, and again, you see this stuff here. I've sanded, and I've put other deals under here. But you can see how crappy that is. And again, here you can see, hopefully, how crappy it is. There's a big gap here. So I put the bottom back on. In this case, I folded it under the cowling, top cowling. All the instructions say this should go over the top cowling here. Well, I'm not sure how you can do that for a couple of reasons. One is, in order to get it over the top cowling and in order to get it to fit over here, this section actually has to fit up under the cowling, I think. So you can't have, you know, half of this over and then this part under and get this part to fit. So one big question is, how do I do that? And in the order of things, when do I do that? Now, I've done what they said to do, which is the same thing I did for the top cowling, which is to draw this line and then draw an edge. But there's a problem right now with slicing that, and that is that the cowling fits under the bottom of the fuselage there, and as soon as I cut that, then all these dimensions are going to change. So the question I have is, which thing do I do next, since anything I cut is going to affect everything else? So it's difficult for me to figure out how to get a proper line to cut, and which of these proper lines do I cut?
And then your mind ends up playing games with you, I think, too. For instance, I'll step back every now and again and look at this thing, and I'll think, you know, that thing looks cockeyed. The way it looks now, unless I've missed something, it looks like it's cockeyed, you know, to that side. But, I mean, I've hung plumb bobs and everything, and I've done the measurements, and everything says it's straight, but it looks cockeyed. So I don't know if this is like flying in instrument conditions or not, where you don't pay attention to what your eyes and your tush are telling you. you pay attention to your instruments. But that's just another complicating factor, especially if you don't have a lot of self-confidence in what you're doing at this stage. The top part came out okay. Not great, but okay. There's maybe a little bit bigger gap than I would have liked there, but I suppose I can clean that up a little bit later. So I'm not too concerned about that. I know I've got a good frame of reference here with the instructions, which were better for the top cowling than the bottom. But again, I'm not sure how to even fit the bottom and again, what I need to do next. And again, the bottom part is a little dicey to me for a couple of reasons. You can see I've got it pretty well up against things, but you can see there's still a little gap here. So even if I cut this here right now, I'm not really sure whether I have a good fit. I obviously don't want to cut too much. And the complicating factor, of course, is that nose gear over there and getting that to fit. Here's a look in the snout. I don't know if you can see it or not, but over there on the top right is where the mixture cable is. And you can probably tell it's either hitting or it's going to hit the side of the cowl. I don't know if it makes sense to do all kinds of screwy things with the mixture or put in a little shelf there or something or cut out to allow it to go freely. I guess I'll figure that out later. Right now that's the least of my worries. And of course the other thing is that this whole thing is going down because it's being pulled down by the weight. I need to figure out how to prop that up so it could be at the right angle to make any decisions on what gets cut here on the bottom. So that's pretty much the problem and where I'm at. You know, I've kind of laid this up there. It looks better than it really is, but do I cut this next? And if I do, how is that line going to change when I cut this part down here that makes it fit kind of flush? Do I cut this next? If I do, what's my reference line here? Because as soon as I make it fit flush, this is going to change a little bit. So that's episode one of the Cowling Chronicles. I'll look forward to hearing from you as to what I should be doing next. Better still, it's a beautiful time of year in South St. Paul, Minnesota. You should come visit.